An NGO set up by Olympic medalist and Indian lawmaker Mary Kom is being probed by the Home Ministry under the foreign funding laws. Opposition leader Sonia Gandhi-led Rajiv Gandhi Charitable Trust is also being probed. This is the latest news coming in that Olympic medalist and Indian lawmaker Mary Kom is being probed by the Home Ministry under the foreign funding laws. And to give us more details on the story, I'm now joined in by political editor Kartike Sharma. Kartike, what are the latest details that you can give us?
What is very, very important here is that this, in a written answer by Kiran Rijiju to question, has been provided. And generally, the names of the NGOs are not mentioned. But this time, what has happened is that the name of the NGOs have been mentioned. For example, Mary Kom's NGO, Rajiv Gandhi Charitable Trust. So what they have done is that they have sent a questionnaire. Now, questionnaire is sent to those where Home Ministry perceive a prima facie irregularity. It does not mean that it will lead to an inquiry. It is a questionnaire which decides whether there should be inquiry or not. But what is new is that a questionnaire has been sent and the names have been put in public domain. I think that's where the story is. And anyway, most of the NGOs are under public scanner after 2014 elections. So again, this will give a twist to Congress-BJP rivalry. And for Congress, it will be an issue of vendetta. And for Bharatiya Janata Party, they'll say that there has been problem with the trust, because anyway, the whole Young India National Herald issue is already sub judice and in the court.
Right. Kartike, also, what are the details that you are getting in regarding Rajiv Gandhi Charitable Trust, which is also being probed?
What has happened is that a questionnaire has been sent, and the questionnaire will ask them about the details of the foreign received money from foreign countries. So now, when you say that you receive funds from foreign countries, you undercome FCRA regulation, which is Foreign Control Regulation Act, which maintains, decides, scrutinizes the data on foreign funding to various institutions in India. Now, what has happened is that someone must have received, or someone must have felt that there is an anomaly. So I must make it clear that it does not mean that there is some culpability. What it does, the questionnaire, is that it wants to see whether it merits an inquiry or not. But generally, the names are not put in public domain. This time they have come.
All right. Kartike, how could this impact the party now with foreign funding being sealed?
No, you see, it's a very problematic issue. Political parties will receive funds, but they don't have to declare the owner. NGOs run into problem because they feel that NGOs somehow have become tools to generate public opinion and interfere in domestic politics. And it is for this reason that post 2014, a lot of internal NGOs operating in the country have come under the FCRA hammer. So a lot of people say that, you know, FCRA is being used like a political tool, but many people would say that NGOs have been interfering in domestic politics. So the argument cuts both ways.
Right, Kartike Sharma there, bringing us all the details on this story. Thank you, Kartike.